This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. James Donald Cameron, May 14, 1833. Having served as chairman on two powerful Senate committees in 1890, Senator Cameron supported the Federal Elections Bill that enforced African American voting rights in the South. After leaving the Senate, Cameron worked in various industrial businesses until his death in 1918. Cameron was the last surviving cabinet member of the Grant administration. Contents: 1. Early life. 2. Banking and railroad career. 3. Secretary of War. 31. Great Sioux War. 32. Presidential election. 1876 crisis. 4. U.S. Senator. 5. Later career. 6. Death and burial. 7. Marriages, family, and estate. 8. References. 9. External links. Early life. James Donald Cameron was born on May 14, 1833 in Middletown, Pennsylvania, in the family home, the first-born son of Simon Cameron, the 26th Secretary of War under President Abraham Lincoln and a powerful Pennsylvania politician. Cameron's mother was Margaret Brewer. Cameron was commonly referred to as Don. Having received his elementary education in Harrisburg, Cameron enrolled in Princeton College, today Princeton University. He graduated with a Bachelor of Arts in 1852 and received a Master of Arts degree in 1855. Banking and railroad career. After leaving Princeton, Cameron's father Simon placed Cameron as a clerk at the successful Middleton Bank, whose main investments were in the iron, coal, and lumber businesses of Pennsylvania. Cameron worked his way up to being cashier and then president of the bank as an executive of the Northern Central Railway during the American Civil War. Cameron managed the flow of supplies and soldiers from the northeastern states to Washington, D.C. and Virginia, including efforts to keep the railroad open despite Confederate attempt to damage or destroy it from 1866 to December 1874. Cameron was president of the Northern Central as bank president. Cameron was able to improve the financial condition of the railroad. After leaving the railroad, Cameron worked in various industrial enterprises in Pennsylvania. Secretary of War. Secretary of War J. Donald Cameron. Huntington, 1877. In 1876, President Ulysses South Grant appointed Cameron to his cabinet as Secretary of War, a post his father once served in during the Lincoln administration, to succeed Alfonso Taft, who became Attorney General, and served as so until the end of Grant's presidency. Cameron's predecessor, Alfonso Taft, had initially replaced William W. Belknap, who had abruptly resigned over taking profit payments from the Fort Sill tradership. The Secretary of War had been given control over all Indian traderships in 1870. Belknap was impeached by the House, and during the summer of 1876 was tried and acquitted by the Senate. Cameron's appointment as Secretary of War was part of a sensational three-move realignment by President Grant. U.S. Attorney General Edwards Pierpont was appointed Minister to England, Secretary Taft was appointed U.S. Attorney General, and Cameron was appointed Secretary of War, on the advice of his father, Senator Simon Cameron. Cameron had never served political office until appointed Secretary of War. Cameron had to quickly acquaint himself with the War Department that was in the midst of fighting the Great Sioux War. After the controversial 1876 presidential election, Cameron had to contend with the Southern states, who threatened to secede from the United States a second time. According to General of the Army William T. Sherman, the U.S. military during 1876 was as active as it had been since the Civil War. Secretary Cameron requested legislation from Congress that required war contractors be required to stand by their bids for a definite time period. Secretary Cameron requested funding from Congress through allocations that paid for the War of Rebellion records, for the preservation of Matthew Brady's American Civil War photographs. The U.S. military, including the Army, headed by Cameron, and Navy, headed by Secretary George M. Robeson, were also in a technological transition, developing submarine technology, and torpedo mines and ships to protect United States waterways and harbors. Great Sioux War. The Battle of the Little Big Horn. Russell, 1903. Without ever holding political office, Secretary of War Cameron had to immediately contend with the Great Sioux War and quickly become acquainted with the bureaucracy of the War Department. When gold was discovered in the Black Hills, miners began to invade Indian territory given by the federal government to the Sioux tribe under the Fort Laramie Treaty of 1868. In addition, the federal government planned to put a route of the Northern Pacific Railroad through the Sioux and Cheyenne buffalo hunting grounds. After negotiation for the sale of Sioux land failed in May 1875, President Grant ordered all non-treaty bands to return to the reservation. When Sitting Bull and Crazy Horse refused to comply, Secretary of Interior Zachariah Chandler handed over the jurisdiction of the hostile Indians to the War Department on January 31, 1876, launching the Great Sioux War. Three battles took place during the summer of 1876 while Cameron was in charge of the War Department, including the Battle of Rosebud, the Battle of the Little Big Horn, and the Battle of Slim Buttes. By October 1876, the War Department, under Secretary Cameron, increased troop levels at Western Indian agencies to crack down on Indian resistance. This was to prevent another massacre that had taken the lives of Colonel George Armstrong Custer and the 7th Cavalry at the Battle of the Little Bighorn. After all hostile Indians were rounded up, a new treaty was signed that ceded the Black Hills to the federal government. Presidential election 1876 crisis. After the controversial presidential election of 1876, the majority of electoral votes for Republican candidate Rutherford B. Hayes and Democratic candidate Samuel J. Tilden were disputed in the reconstructed states of Louisiana and Florida. Secretary of War Cameron allowed military troops stationed in both contested states to be at the disposal of Republican politicians. Previously, in June 1876 at the Republican National Convention, Secretary Cameron was instrumental in nominating Hayes as the Republican candidate. According to a report by General of the Army William T. Sherman, Southern states threatened to secede from the Union if Tilden was not elected. President Ulysses S. Grant responded through the War Department by having troops concentrated in Louisiana under Brigadier General Christopher C. Augurin. Reinforced in North Carolina under Brigadier General Thomas H. Ruger. These stationed troops and the delicate and prudent actions of both generals, Augur and Ruger, to keep peace, prevented a second Civil War. A presidential commission set up by Congress and President Grant in 1877 finally chose Hayes to be elected President of the United States. Cameron's father, Senator Simon Cameron, and other Republican politicians lobbied President Hayes that Cameron remain Secretary of War. However, President Hayes refused, not wanting to be part of any Cameron political dynasty and having desired to nominate his own cabinet. U.S. Senator Will He Cast His Sword Into the Balance. An 1882 Puck cartoon depicts Cameron and fellow Pennsylvania Senator John I. Mitchell on the Republican Pennsylvania scale. Cameron, sitting on a platform marked bossism, attempts to weigh himself down with weights marked threats, tricks, and bluster, while Mitchell, dressed as a Roman, stands at the opposite end as an independent Republican. President Chester A. Arthur, too dressed as a Roman, holds a sword marked patronage, which Cameron asks for to even out the balance. In March 1877, his father resigned his seat in the United States Senate, after receiving assurance that his son would be elected to succeed him. Later that month, Cameron was elected by the Pennsylvania legislature. He was re-elected three more times, serving for a total of 20 years. He served as chairman of the Committee on Naval Affairs from 1881 to 1891 and again from 1895 to 1897, and as chairman of the Committee on Revolutionary Claims from 1893 to 1895. Cameron also served as chairman of the Republican National Committee from 1879 to 1880. Cameron was an active politician who, with the initial aid of his father Simon Cameron, and his political ally Matthew Key, set up a political machine in the Pennsylvania legislature that ensured Cameron would be re-elected to office. Senator Cameron rarely gave speeches, and he was viewed as being judicious, unemotional, and reticent. Cameron disapproved of the popular artful oratory methods used by his contemporaries, while his own speeches were forceful and direct, adopting his father's method. Cameron's strength as a politician relied on working inside the antechamber, committees, and caucuses to obtain his goals. Cameron distinguished himself in the Senate in 1890 when he supported the Federal Elections Bill that ensured African Americans' voting protection rights in the Solid South. However, on the whole, Cameron's nearly 20 years in the Senate remained undistinguished, while for the most part he voted on the Republican Party line. Later career. After not being a candidate for re-election in 1896, Cameron engaged in several business enterprises in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Death and burial. Cameron died on August 30, 1918 at his country home called Donegal Cameron Estate in Lancaster County, Pennsylvania. Cameron was interred at Harrisburg Cemetery in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Cameron was the last surviving cabinet member of the Grant administration. Marriages, family, and estate. Donegal Cameron married Mary McCormick on May 20, 1856, and together they had six children: Eliza McCormick Cameron, born 1857, who married William H. Bradley; Virginia Rillette Cameron, born 1860, 1861, who married Lieutenant Alexander Rogers, James McCormick Cameron born 1865, Mary Cameron born 1867, Margareta Brewer Cameron born 1869, who married John William Clark, and Rachel Burnside Cameron born 1871. Cameron's second wife, the former Elizabeth Sherman, whom he married in 1878, was the niece of William Tecumseh Sherman and John Sherman and a close friend of Henry Brooks Adams. Their daughter, Martha Cameron born 1886, married Sir Ronald Charles Lindsay in 1909. When Cameron died in 1918, his estate had been put in trust and was worth $4 million, $41,200,000. 2011 Cameron had purchased his father Simon Cameron's affectionately known farm estate, Donegal, on the Susquehanna River in Lancaster County. Cameron lived at Donegal during the summer, while during the winter he lived on his house boat off the South Carolina coast. References: Carrot A. B. Bell, 1981, Secretaries of War and Secretaries of the Army, pp. 3-4. Carrot A. B. C. D. E. F. G. New York Times, May 23, 1876, The Presidency. Carrot A. B. Bell, 1981, Secretaries of War and Secretaries of the Army, p. 82. Carrot M. John Lubetkin, J. Cooks Gamble, The Northern Pacific Railroad, The Sioux, and the Panic of 1873. Norman, University of Oklahoma Press, 2006. Carrot Grisk, pp. 64-69. Carrot Commissioner of Indian Affairs to Secretary of the Interior, January 31, 1876, Secretary of the Interior to the Secretary of War, February 1, 1876, Colonel Drum to Gen Terry and Gen Crook, February 8, 1876, National Archives. Carrot ABCD Dictionary of American Biography, Volume 3, p. 435. Carrot ABC Cameron, November 20, 1876, Annual Report of the Secretary of War, Volume 1, p. 5. Carrot Hayes v. Tilden, The Electoral College Controversy of 1876-1877, Harpweek Archived, February 20, 2006, at the Wayback Machine. Carrot Dictionary of American Biography, Volume 3, pp. 435-436. Carrot ABCDE Dictionary of American Biography, Volume 3, p. 436. Carrot Center for Pennsylvania Culture Studies, Mary McCormick, Penn State Harrisburg. Retrieved 13 June 2008. J. Donald Cameron at Find a Grave. J. Donald Cameron Biography and Secretaries of War and Secretaries of the Army, a publication of the United States Army Center of Military History. Bird's Eye View of Cameron's Donegal Estate. Bing Maps Political Offices preceded. Served alongside William A. Wallace, John I. Mitchell and Matthew S. Key succeeded. Ross S. McClay, Lieb Roberts, Findlay Barnard, Dallas McKean, Sturgeon Broadhead S. Cameron, Wilmot Buckaloo, J. Scott Wallace, Mitchell Key Knox, Oliver Knox, Crow Reed, Guffey Martin, H. Scott Hines, Wofford Santorum, Casey Class 3, Morris Bingham, Mullenberg Logan, Greg Lackick, Lowry Marks, Wilkins Buchanan S. Cameron, Cooper Beigler, Cowan S. Cameron, J. Cameron, Penrose Pepper, Vare Grundy, Davis Myers, Duff Clark, Schweiker Specter. Toomey notes: never officially seated VE U.S. Secretaries of War in the Army. U.S. Department of War 1789-1949. Secretaries of War B. Lincoln, Knox, Pickering, McHenry, Dexter, Dearborn, Eustace Armstrong, Monroe W. Crawford, Calhoun, Barber P. Porter, Eaton, Cass, Poinsett, Bell, Spencer J. Porter, Wilkins, Marcy G. Crawford, Conrad J. Davis, Floyd Holt S. Cameron, Stanton, Schofield, Rollins, Belknap A. Taft, J. Cameron, McCrary, Ramsey R. Lincoln, Endicott, Proctor, Elkins, Lamont, Alger, Root W. Taft, Wright, Dickinson, Stimson, Garrison, Baker, Weeks, D. Davis, Good, Hurley, Dern, Woodring, Stimson, Patterson, Royal Assistant Secretaries of War, Scott Watson, Tucker, Walcott, Dana Eckert, Grant Doe, Meeklejohn, Sanger, Oliver, Breckinridge, Ingram, Crowell, Williams, Wainwright, D. Davis, McNider, Hurley Payne, Woodring L. Johnson, Patterson, McCloy, Peterson. U.S. Department of the Army 1949 Present Secretaries of the Army Royal Gray Pace Stevens Brucker. Star Vance Ailes Resor Frolk Callaway Hoffman C. Alexander Marsh Stone West Caldera White Harvey Guerin McHugh Fanning Under Secretaries of the Army Draper Gray Voorhees A. Alexander Bendetson E. Johnson Slezak Finnecane Milton Ailes Ignatius Resor McGifford Beale Bellew Stott Augustine Lauberg Ambrose Stone Shannon Reeder Walker Rostker Dahlberg Brownlee Guerin Ford Westfall Carson Murphy V.E. Chairman of the United States Senate Committee on Armed Services Military Affairs Committee 1816-1947 J. Williams Troop J. Williams Jackson Harrison Benton Preston Crittenden Benton Cass Benton Davis Shields Weller Davis Johnson Wilson Logan Spencer Randolph Logan Sewell Holly Walthall Holly Proctor Warren DuPont Johnston Chamberlain Wadsworth Reed Shepard Reynolds Thomas Naval Affairs Committee 1816-1947 Tate Sanford Pleasance Lloyd Hain Dallas Southard Rives R. Williams Mangum Bayard Fairfield Uly Gwyn Mallory J. Hale Grimes Cragen Sergeant McPherson Cameron E. Hale Perkins Tillman Swanson Page F. Hale Trammell Walsh Armed Services Committee 1947 Present Gurney Tidings Russell Saltonstall Russell Stennis Tower Goldwater Nunn Thurmond Warner Levin Warner Levin Warner Levin McCain V.E. United States Republican Party Chairpersons of the RNC Morgan Raymond Ward Claflin Morgan Chandler Cameron Jewell Sabin Jones Key Clarkson Carter Hannah Payne Cortelyou New Hitchcock Hill Rosewater Hills Wilcox Hayes Adams Butler Work Houston Fess Sanders Fletcher Hamilton Martin Walsh Spangler Brownell Reese Scott Gabrielson Summerfield Roberts Hall Alcorn T.B. Morton Miller Birch Bliss R. Morton Dole Bush Smith Brock Richards Laxalt, Fahrenkopf Reagan, Fahrenkopf Atwater Uter Bond Barber Nicholson Gilmore Rassicott Gillespie Melman Martinez Duncan Steele Priebus Presidential Tickets Fremont, Dayton. Lincoln, Hamlin Lincoln, Johnson Grant, Colfax Grant, Wilson Hayes, Wheeler Garfield, Arthur Blaine, Logan Harrison, Morton Harrison, Reed McKinley, Hobart McKinley, Roosevelt Roosevelt, Fairbanks Taft, Sherman, Butler Hughes, Fairbanks Harding, Coolidge Coolidge, Dawes Hoover, Curtis Twice. Landon, Knox Wilkie, McNary Dewey, Bricker Dewey, Warren Eisenhower, Nixon Twice Nixon, Lodge Goldwater, Miller Nixon, Agnew Twice Ford, Dole Reagan, G. H. W. Bush Twice G. H. W. Bush, Quayle Twice Dole, Kemp G. W. Bush, Cheney Twice McCain, Palin Romney, Ryan Trump, Pence Parties by State and Territory. State Alabama Alaska Arizona Arkansas California Colorado Connecticut Delaware Florida Georgia Hawaii Idaho Illinois Indiana Iowa Kansas Kentucky Louisiana Maine Maryland Massachusetts Michigan Minnesota Mississippi Missouri Montana Nebraska Nevada New Hampshire New Jersey New Mexico New York North Carolina North Dakota Ohio Oklahoma, Oregon, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, South Carolina, South Dakota, Tennessee, Texas, Utah, Vermont, Virginia, Washington, West Virginia, Wisconsin, Wyoming Territory, American Samoa, District of Columbia.